Odotei. Congrats for winning that seat for the New Patriotic Party. We're very proud of your exploits and the fact that you beat the very loud former Member of Parliament, Mr. Namwale. Having said that, I want to find out from you, and the people of Lora are listening. They sent a question that I should ask you. There are four secondary schools in Lora. None of them has internet facilities. But they have an ICT lab. And in two communities, Ermo and Dumen and Bo, in fact, there's no internet service. There's no network of all these telcos, none of them, MTN, Tigo, all the networks we have, you can't get service over the mobile service. So when people are sick, it's difficult to call the hospital ambulance to even pick up anybody. It's a major problem in these communities. Your minister is sitting right next. Your deputy, your colleague deputy is here. I want you to assure this committee and the people of Lora watching that you will address this issue urgently. It's a very urgent issue.
I think that, as you said, my minister is here during her vetting. She assured the whole nation that these dark spots where there's no connectivity, as a ministry, we are going to address them. And I can assure you that, as my honorable minister said, we are going to tackle them to ensure that the issue of the universal access becomes a reality. Thank you very much.
My next question has to do with your CV. You have been the chief executive officer of Accra House of Oak, one of Ghana's oldest club and most successful. And we are very happy with the results the last time, anyway, just to add. But at the same time, I want to find out what your take is in respect to the local league and sponsorship from Corporate Ghana, and what you can do with your experience in football management and how the telcos can help restore the local league. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Honorable. Sponsorship is not a philanthropy. It's no philanthropy. Those of us who are into sports must realize that sporting activities are entertainment products. And telcos and third-party corporate bodies require a platform which can give them visibility, which they can use to communicate their brand. So for the telcos and other third-party companies that you want to come into sports, we must ensure that the products that we provide, the entertainment, is fit for purpose. That's the only way that they will be able to attract them, and so that they will ensure that we provide them the opportunity to use the sporting platform to communicate their brands. So what we need to do, and unfortunately, our sporting industry in the country has really fallen behind other industries in the application, in the adoption, and the use of modern management techniques to build their brands. That is why we see that we are not able to attract sponsorship. What a lot of people don't realize is that people, for example, football clubs are not in the business of football. They are in the entertainment business through football for a profit. Once you begin to look at products in a competitive manner, there are certain ways that you must structure them to give value. Unfortunately, that's what we've not been able to do. That's why the telcos are very reluctant, and other people are reluctant, unlike other countries, to provide value. One of the most objective and unbiased assessments of whether the product we are providing is fit for purpose is that people don't go to stadium. They are our main customers, both the live audience and then the live audience. They don't do that. So no one will come and associate with you. We need to reform, and that's the only way we'll be able to attract sponsorship. Thank you very much.
Mm-hmm. Okay,
well, there appears to be a conspiracy of House supporters. You know, they only mean that there's a house match when they finish. A lot of conspiracy going on here. Quater, please.
Mr. Chairman, I'm a great Olympics fan. So, you know, we should come now. Cool down, cool down. There is this perception that football officiating the commercial interest is more important than the real handling of officiating. In other words, the investment in the game where refereeing officiating matches, the interest in that area is more prominent than the real match itself. Do you agree to that school of thought? Because I have witnessed a middle leg match being played at Sappers Station, where a team was badly handled in terms of officiating. I have to step in and told the managers that the way they handle the matches is not in the interest of football. I've been an active footballer before. So when you see a match being badly officiated, you can see there is that commercial interest these days that is gaining grounds in football, that instead of the referees handling the matches the way it is, they look at commercial interest and all that. What do you think is the cause and what can be done about it?
Are you saying that the referees consider the commercial aspects instead of considering what the technical decisions for them to take?
Exactly so.
I'm not too sure about that. I don't have any reason. I'm not too sure about that. There could be lapses where they are not, but I'm not too sure about that.
My second question is the chairman. You are part of the Parliamentary Select Committee Trade, Industry and Tourism when we visited Trade Fair site, and we were not happy with the presentation that was given to us by the chief executive and his team. There are some recommendations that were made that we're yet to bring to Parliament for discussion and all that. As their voice, what do you think you can do now that you've had opportunity to go into government so that we can bring Trade Fair back to its normal self? When we're kids, we all go to Trade Fair and all that. What do you think you can do now that you have the opportunity to come and serve in government so that the people of La can benefit, i.e. in terms of their compensation, how Trade Fair can be brought up to create jobs for the youth in La and all that? Thank you.
Thank you very much. I think I was just a friend of the committee that visited Trade Fair. As you rightly said, this really under the remit of the Ministry of Trade and Industry. Since it's actually situated on my land, I'm sure I'll get closer to the Ministry of Trade and the Industry to ensure that the interests of the people and then the. I think the issue is that, Mr. Chairman, the issue is that the Trade Fair is in the state in which it is, because it's not fit for purpose. And I'm sure based on the accommodation discussions we had there, once we'll get closer to the Ministry of Trade to see how we can build it to be a competitive exhibition site. For Trade Fair to go back to what it used to be, we may have to have a second look at it, because things have changed and things are different now.
All right, Honorable Chairman. All
right, thank you, Mr. Chairman. Congratulations, Honorable. Yes, there's something I want to know. Would you agree to the assertion that the more foreign stake in our telecommunication industry? And if it is so, what will you do to assist your minister to increase the local participation within the industry? And is there a local content law in this, in the telecom industry? Thank you.
Yeah, thank you very much. I think one of the means in any industry that you get local participation if you go through the stock market. So if, as a ministry, we think it's, we'll have a look at it, the policies that we go through so that local people can own part of it through the stock exchange, I think I'll support my minister to do that.
Anyway, thank you very
much. And within a minute, they said, your unit is finished. What can you do to help us, I mean the consumers? To
thank you very much. Sorry, Anna, are you finished?
You buy a unit on your phone, and within a twinkle of an eye, it says you have to recharge again. It means that the customers have been cheated. What can we do to protect the customer?
Thank you very much. I think that the first step is to all of us. I think we need to be educated on how to bundle the credit that we buy, because we are moving right into broadband, where data is quite expensive. So we need to be educated to ensure that we don't just recharge now, but we bundle it to ensure that we have long usage for the credit that we pay. With regard to, I'm sure during the interview of the virtue of my minister, she made it clear there's the issue about consumer protection which is going to come in. They will look into those matters to ensure that there's fair competition. But I think it's more to do with education and bonding. Thank you very much.
Around the Paripari Tokurame in the Karachi East area. For a month, we are not seeing anything. Really reinforce that. It is as if when you sit
here. The minister is here. She says that you're putting words in her mouth. Let me clarify what
I have no recollection of making any such promise during my vetting. Which town did you say I said I was going to
say? I mentioned Paripari, Tokurano, and Asukoko. And you promised that when you come, when you take office, you are going to do that.
Thank
you. I've not seen any.
That case leave the deputy minister out. So the minister will take care of it.
So she has been in office for one month. I've not seen anything. Will you assure us that when you come, you are going to help us?
Honorable Nobri, please. You can't answer for the minister's promise to Paripari people. I'm sure that the minister is here. She's a member of this committee. She knows her office in the ministry. You will follow up with the minister. If you want to ask another question, I permit you.
Now that minister says she didn't say it, I know that when I ask another question. But on a more serious note, it means that you are going to incorporate education in your programs now. Because it's like, if you don't include education, then you might not know how to use our units. So will you assure us that you will educate the masses as to what to do to optimally utilize our units?
Thank you very much, Mr. Chairman. Sorry. Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Yes, definitely. I think during the vetting of my minister, she indicated we are going to engage in some stakeholder engagement with all the telcos, the users, consumers, and MNOs to educate them on how to ensure that, efficient use of the investment, that the things that they buy, not just that, on all aspects of what we are doing in the communication industry. Thank you very much.
Okay, Barbara.
Thank you.
Looking at your minister, she's part of this committee. I know she believes in standards. I want to find out from you what you do to assist her make the Ministry of Communication an outstanding one. Thank you.
Let me say how privileged I feel to be working with my minister and my other colleague. I think my minister has proven beyond every doubt that she's very capable, a very good leader. when you look at her record. I think that when you look at her background, coming from patients background, private sector, sports, community, and I believe that I'll be able to bring my diverse experiences to add to and to support my minister and the whole and the whole communications ministry. I'm driven by the president's clarion call for a Ghana beyond aid. And when you look at your role, my postgraduate is in strategy. I believe in trying to position this country to continue to hold on to leadership in deregulation, globalization, and communication industry, and the capacity that we have to make this country competitive in terms of communication infrastructure, and so that we will continue to attract a lot of people, because we live in a communication age. So we need to position ourselves if we are to be sustainably competitive, and this is a background that I'll bring to support my minister and my other colleague, and to ensure that the service quality that we will provide in this country becomes number one on the African continent.
I want to find out from you what you would be remembered for after 4 years. What you would be remembered for, thank you. What you would like to be remembered for, thank you.
Okay, thank you very much. I would really love to be remembered as someone who supported his minister and the communications ministry and the whole team, and the whole team of all the agencies we're going to work with to provide the best IT infrastructure and the best transformation in the communication industry. That's what I want to be remembered for.
Honorable nominee, congratulations once again.
Thank you very much.
I want to ask you, the telecommunication companies usually erect masts in various communities and all that. My concern, which I would want to know how you would be addressing it, is situations where they trespass on other people's property to mount these masts. I have a personal experience in my garden. I was away in church, in front of my house where I've done my small garden. In the middle of the front view of my house, there was a mast being mounted. I'm sure many Ghanaians have experienced seeing. How would you address a situation like this? And how would you advise your minister on the way forward? Thank you.
Thank you very much. I think the action of a mast being erected on your private property, it's without your permission, it's against the law. So I'm sure I'll be supporting my minister for us to address this, to ensure that before a mast is erected anywhere in the country, the environmental protection, the stakeholder, all the stakeholders, the permits that must be required, like any other installation to be done, are acquired. Because for them to just come in into your private property is against the law. Thank you very much.
Are you aware the human being or the contact could be hazardous medically? Is that so? There's no empirical study on that. But you know that is the mentality of many Ghanaians. So if we want to promote and widen up the scope of communication in our country, and we have this perception on the minds of people, I'm sure it's not the first time you're hearing this. How would you address the situation so that people come to terms with the fact that ICT or communication, telecommunication has become a part of us, and that there's actually nothing wrong with these masts provided they are mounted at the right places. What would you do?
Thank you very much. Well, first of all, I'm not aware of any empirical evidence that these masts emit the kind of radiation that people say. I'm not aware of that. However, these things are critical infrastructure which is required for us to be able to expand and pursue the policy of the universal access. So as our support to our minister and the whole ministry, for us to engage all stakeholders, especially, I mean, all those involved in related to this erection of mass, so that one, they realize that we need this infrastructure if we are to improve the service and ensure that we embrace the drive for the broadband experience. So then engage, educate them via all stakeholders on the need for them to accept that, and then for them to know, to assuage their fears that such things are not really true until proven otherwise scientifically. Thank you very much.
Lastly, what are the ministry to assist your minister perform? What are the qualities that we should expect on the job?
First of all, I think it's teamwork. To manage Accra Hearts of Oak, you must know that you need to take everybody on board. And apart from that, I have a very, very insatiable appetite and desire for performance and transformation. I recall the first question the Honorable Kabo asked me about the elections, how we were able to do it in Ladda, Dekopa, which was thought impossible. Yes, I have that insatiable desire and the leadership quality to support my minister. And I'm sure you realize that I've also been worked the public service for some time. So I want to bring all these things to bear for the whole team to succeed, and hopefully make sure that wherever my minister goes, me and my colleague, we follow her to wherever we go. But we want to work as a good team.
You follow her wherever she goes. That's a very dangerous statement. Mr. Ekufo won't be happy.
It's work-related, because already I'm learning so much from her and my other colleagues, and it's really a nice experience. It's only work-related. Thank you very much.
I don't want to repeat that. You don't want to?
Yeah.
Okay. Weird.
Sharp.
I saw that you had requested on the Uganda's Ghana platform that the choir should be here. Are they here?
I'm not aware. I was never a choir master, just a JCR president. So I don't know whether since they've been here, since you're a choir master, whether they've come to pay homage. So maybe.
I didn't request them to come. Notwithstanding that I was a choir master, I didn't request them to come. You asked them to come, but I haven't seen anybody here so far. Well, at least it's only the hall that they make papa. They couldn't able. They could come here. Well, I have no questions for you.